Hey guys, what's up? It's Pixelated Apollo. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are doing well. And today we have a sneak peek to a new mod for Empire Total War. It's still a work in progress, but it's based around the American Revolution. It is called Regiments of American Revolution. So obviously, you're going to see a lot of cool regiments for the American and British roster. So you're going to see a lot of awesome uniforms. You guys know how much I love my uniforms, especially during this time period. Not only are there going to be new units, but also there's some new mechanics here. You see the space in between the regiments here. I did not deploy like this on purpose. It automatically does that whenever you stretch out your lines. It adds the space to it, which I think is really awesome because it feels a lot more realistic. Now, I'm no expert in this time period, but I'm pretty sure there would be a bit of a space in between the regiments as they fight so they can easily get in position and whatnot. So it's got this really nice realistic vibe to it. Also, it's got some really cool sound effects, so I'm pretty excited for today's battle, especially since I am playing as America and I am taking on Jackie Fish and he is leading the Redcoats. We're both representing our countries here, so hopefully I can lead these American boys to victory. So let's go ahead and look at the army comps. We're still in the deployment phase here because it does start off very quickly, but I'm gonna go super slow during these during the army comps. Had a brain fart there. I'm gonna go super slow during the RV comps because I really want to show you the detail in the uniforms. So starting with my artillery, I have two artillery. So yeah, they're just called artillery. Look at this guy's face. Look, he's like, I'm so ready. He had such an angry face on. He's so ready to blow up the British. And then I have two units of the 26th Continental Regiment Grenadier Company. They're also known as Washington's Grenadiers. Look pretty awesome. And then moving on to my line infantry, I've got one unit of the Continental Light Infantry Company. Oh man, look at the officer here. Look at that, that is great. And then I have two units of the Continental Militia, so the heart of the American Army, especially during this time period. And let's see, more militia here. And then I've got the 2nd South Carolina Regiment. Nice line infantry here. I tried to get one of everything so you could really show them off. Here is the 1st New Hampshire Regiment. Very sick uniform. I like the different color pants. I don't know why I like that so much, but it has this more realistic feeling to it. Very, very cool. And then moving on, I have the 3rd New Jersey Jersey Blue Regiment. So there's another nice white and blue uniform. And the very end here, I have the Continental Regulars North. So pretty sweet. Back here, I have some reserves. This is the Commander-in-Chief Guard Company. Thought their unit name was really awesome, so I had to bring them. They're pretty much like the Marines. Very awesome. And over on this side, I think that's it. Yeah, that's everything for line infantry. For Cav, I have my general here, the Continental General Bodyguard. Let's see if we can actually see the general. Oh, here he is. Looks kind of like Washington. I think he was going for, you know, a Washington general. And then I have one unit of the 2nd Light Dragoon. And I have one unit of the 3rd Light Dragoon. So those are my my Cav forces. Now for my light infantry, I have three units of Morgan's Rifleman Corp. Or Corps, I should say. So that's my army, ready to kill for a new country. So we're going to go ahead and actually fast forward here and start the battle so we can go ahead and see Jackie Fish's army. I like how there's a bit of a haze on the battlefield. It's a bit of a fog. It's going to make things very interesting. So there we go. Okay, slow motion here. So we have time to look at his forces. So Jackie Fish's army, he's got the 6-pounder Royal Artillery. Oh man, just I love these uniforms, especially Great Britain, man. The uniforms are amazing. The 7th Regiment Light Company, so some light guns here. Back here, he has the 17th Regiment Grenadier Company. And moving up, he has some Cav here. He's got the Tarleton Light Dragoons, and he has the 17th Light Dragoons. Look at, they've got skull and crossbones on their helmet there. And then he's bringing the 23rd Regiment Middle Company. Middle Company! And then over here, he's got another Middle Company. Let's see, he's got the 33rd Regiment Veterans. Oh, look at the fancy hats on these guys. And then over on this side, he's got another veteran unit. is bringing the 7th Regiment Grenadier Company. And he has the 33rd Regiment Light Infantry Company. On this flank, he's got the 23rd Royal Welsh Regiment Grenadier Company. Look at this guy. Look at him. Oh, my God. And then he's got another one. And over here is the 43rd Regiment Battalion Company. And I think he's got another, Battalion Company. Back here, he has the 62nd Regiment Battalion Company. So that is pretty much Jackie Fish's army. I think he has a couple lights here somewhere, but he is pushing up the artillery. I think he's going to go ahead and get ready to unlimber. We'll go ahead and press play here and start the slaughter. And this is a bit of a race for superior terrain. So I am moving forward pretty quickly. Let me go ahead and show you some marching shots here. This is my militia being one of the first ones to charge in, the Minutemen. I'm trying to quickly get my artillery in position. I'm going to go ahead and try to put my artillery up on this slight ridge over here so it has a good angle to the enemy. And I'm also pushing a little bit to the flank here. I've got a lot of lights in my army. So here's the Continental Light Infantry Corps, or company, sorry, not corps. So I got them in skirmish formation just in case. And I noticed that Jackie Fish is mostly moving his cav over to this flank. This is his 17th Light Dragoons here. Yeah, so I went ahead and decided to send one of my cav units over to that side. Eventually, there we go, I'm sending him over. I'm sending over my 2nd Light Dragoons, just in case he tries to cav charge me. Look at the backpacks for the Jersey Blue Regiment. Jersey Blues, look at that. That is so sexy, that is nice. I do really like that one. So we're going to get pretty close to a gunfight here. My lights were open, very vulnerable to a cav charge. So I was a little worried about that. I went ahead and held my ground. Got a volley off, and I'm going to go ahead and retreat. Fall back to the tree line. And my cav is close behind, just in case I do get charged here. So I'm going to hold back here. I do have some line infantry close behind as well. This is the Grenadiers. I'm going to be flanking with the Grenadiers, try to get them into melee. And now we are in range. I'm about to take on his light infantry. So we're staying low. See, we're taking on, what is this? The 7th Regiment Light Company. They're firing back now. So it's a pretty intense, nice little light skirmish going on. His artillery is already firing. Let's hear this. Oh! Okay, sound effects a little messed up there, but there is a sound mod for the artillery. So not only do the guns sound different, but the artillery also sounds different. So let's hear one more volley here. It's going to take him a while, whatever. We'll just look back over here because there's some pretty important stuff going on. I was able to hold my ground and actually break some of his cav, which is really surprising. So I just shot him to death. I think he was trying to run away, but he was a little too slow, so I shot a lot of his cav in the back. So I am making great progress over on this flank. Moving up my light infantry, going to continue to push from a distance and fire at his artillery, which is exposed now. They don't have any line infantry protecting it, so I'm going to try to take out that position. My artillery, I guess it's dead? Where did they go? Okay, well, my artillery, I guess they got wiped out there from enemy artillery. That's crazy. I didn't even see that happen. But I am forming up my line infantry here. Gonna get ready for a pretty intense line battle in the center. Here's the light company that is wavering to my my troops. I'm moving up some of my Continental regulars. They're getting into position, ready to fire. Come on, boys, give them hell. Here we go. I don't think they fire by rank in this mod. They just kind of fire at will. Here we go. Yeah, take that. So that should wipe out these light infantry company here. Look at that. And we wiped out these Grenadiers. One volley. That's kind of crazy. A little ridiculous for my liking. Hopefully a regiment can withstand one volley and then charge in. But here's a nice Grenadier charge into my 1st New Hampshire regiment. My lights are awfully close over here too. This is Morgan's Rifleman Corps. Core. But doesn't this just, look at that, the 43 on their backpacks. That is awesome. There's a lot of great, see, it's just the detail in this mod really makes it feel lifelike. But this is a pretty intense fight. I'm trying to form up my line infantry. I'm retreating my lights. They've done enough justice today. And now it's the line infantry's turn to fire back. There we go. We're doing a lot of damage to those damn redcoats. Get out of our country. It's ours now. But look at that. The 23rd, man. It says 23, but they're the... Yeah, there we go. The 23rd Regiment. I was looking at the 7th Light Infantry. I was like, what? Why are they the 7th but have 23 on their backs? So yeah, they're trying to hold the center, but I outnumber them by a lot of troops. Let's see how things are going on this flank. He did charge into my troops. I wasn't paying attention. But I went ahead and just held my ground with my 2nd Light Dragoons, holding off his cap. I do have some support of the Light Infantry, turning the tide of this small engagement. And I am victorious over here. So that is Jackie Fisher's cab. He is off the battlefield. I'm trying to quickly form up my Washington Grenadiers. He's got a really nice hill position. He's doing a lot of damage here. This is his 17th Regiment Grenadier Company. Oh, fire back, baby. Yes, I don't know what it is about this time period. I love these gun battles. It is so cool. And my militia is holding the center line. Brave, brave militia. They're fighting next to the 2nd South Carolina Regiment. And we're still trying to take this hill over here. I am making some progress. We held back his Grenadier charge. So this battle, the battle feels like it's going super fast. When I was playing this live, it seemed to be, you know, going a lot slower. But I gotta make sure not to miss anything. So with my very awesome Commander-in-Chief Guard Company, I'm going way on the flank, and I'm going to try to break down his defense. He has one unit of the 62nd Regiment Battalion Company. Words are hard. Oh, man. So, yeah, I'm going to try to break through them. I do have support of some skirmishers firing at the flank here, the Morgan's Rifleman Corps. And I'm not really making a lot of progress over here. Firing into the dirt. Don't know what I'm doing there. I need to get into a much better position. I think some of the troops on the end are, well, they don't really have a good shot either. But here's a nice bird's eye view of the situation. Pretty awesome, man. I really am enjoying this mod. Just the detail alone in the uniforms, it's got me super hyped. I mean, I can't get over this backpack over here. That is gorgeous. All right, so let's see what's going on over here. He did form square. I think we missed a cap charge, but I charged in my Grenadiers there, cleaned up some of his infantry. He does have some cav here, British General. This is his bodyguard. So yeah, I charged in. Let's see, I'm going to form up on this hill. Come on, Grenadiers, form up. You are Washington's Grenadiers. Except they wouldn't have a British accent, so it's like, you would be, you know, you are Washington's Grenadiers. So form up. Now I'm going to try to fire from this ridge line here. That. Come on, fire, Grenadiers. He is falling back, which is a wise decision. Get out of there quickly. Oh, shots fired. Let's see if I do any damage. I don't think so. But we are breaking them in the center. This is really good. My militia is holding their ground, proving themselves in battle. And we were able to push forward here. And we're going to continue to take this hill. We're making some great progress here. What happens, it seems like the morale in this mod is really, really, like, the morale of the troops, they're very timid. So, you'll see a lot of the times, like, troops just standing there, because they'll break and then recover from breaking, and we won't realize that they have returned to the battle. So, sometimes you'll see, like, regiments just kind of standing there doing nothing. But let's see this last stand here by Jackie Fish. His veterans, oh, that guy got shot. Come on, fire back. Oh, look at these backpacks, man. Play those drums. All right, see what's going on. He's trying to hold the flank here with the 17th Regiment Grenadier Company. And his general is now joining the battle. He's got his rifles here, his mounted rifles, doing some damage. And he's going to go ahead and charge into my Grenadiers. Actually, he's going to continue to skirmish them. I really wasn't paying attention on this side, so I am not aware of his cap just kind of standing there picking off my men. I'm moving up my lights over to this ridge because they do have longer range. Hopefully, I can kind of skirmish down those forces. And he's going to go ahead and fall back his general. That's a very wise decision. You do not want to get cut. You don't want to get caught in a line battle between grenadiers. But he's starting to make some progress over here. He's actually breaking my first New Hampshire regiment. And I'm really just down to Morgan Rifles, Rifleman Corps. Sorry, I got to get used to these names. I'm not used to them. I'm also flanking with my Commander-in-Chief Guard Company. Not a great angle on this light infantry. But I didn't even realize he had a hidden unit in the trees here. That's his 62nd Regiment Battalion Company. And he's about to sandwich in my my force here. So this is where I go ahead and... Well, actually, I don't realize that he's attacking me just yet. And there we go. Now I realize he's behind me. I form square to fight on multiple flanks. You got the guy in the center holding the American flag. Beautiful. He's like, yes, we will not waver. And now I'm moving down my dragoons, my third light dragoons. They're gonna try to, oh, they're gonna fire. Let's see. God, those white uniforms, man, that is nice. That is a fresh look. So yeah, my regiment here, they are in desperate need of support. Come on, stop reforming square. Just hold your ground. Come on, Cav. What are you doing? What are you doing? I don't know. I guess I was focusing on another part of the battle. But he is pushing down more line infantry this way. The 43rd Regiment Battalion Company moving in. We are doing some damage. We do have a very intense line battle over here. This is the Continental Regulars North. We are breaking the will of the enemy. And I am completely winning on this flank. Fighting down his grenadiers. It's a battle of grenadiers here. God, this is awesome. This is a really great mod. Alright, now he's gonna do a charge here, I believe. Come on, lights. Pick him off, his grenadiers. Oh, okay, here we go. This is where I dismount my cav, and I'm gonna use my dragoons properly and form up and try to fight off his square formation. Because I was going to charge my cav into their ranks. But yeah, he formed square, which is not good. Oh my god, are my guys even firing? Do they fire in square? What are they doing? Oh, there we go. We broke the British up on this hill. And that was really Jackie Fish's last advantage. He is pushing some troops this way. This is his veterans. Not really paying attention. Looks like I'm firing on a house. I mean, what do you expect from militia? But yeah, they are about to get flanked, outflanked here. And we are victorious over here. We broke the final defense defending this flank. And now my grenadiers will march over their dead bodies victoriously. And we have a massive chain route from the British. And more troops breaking this way. So my dragoons formed a line here. And they fired at what was left of the British forces. And that is going to wrap up today's battle. So that was a pretty close one. It was really a battle of terrain. This is our first time ever playing this mod, so we didn't really know what to expect. Definitely a strange morale. Well, compared to the vanilla, the morale is a lot different, where it just seems like troops really break easily, which is, I don't know, I don't really want to see the grenadiers break so easily, especially after one volley, because they're kind of like made for that, you know, getting up close and, you know, charging in with their bayonets. But yeah, here's the results. I got a decent amount of kills. It was a pretty close one. Let's see who did the best. First New Hampshire Regiment, 165 kills. Second South Carolina Regiment, 133. And everyone seemed to do pretty well there. So yeah, that's gonna wrap it up, guys. Hopefully this gives you a good view of the mod. I'm definitely gonna try out more battles in the future. I would love to do some historical battles and whatnot. But a good game to Jackie Fish. That was a lot of fun. And I hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, share, subscribe if you haven't. You want to see more. So one more time, guys. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.